Hey, do you know where she's from, by the way, Chun? Do you have any idea?
She is mixed and has one Asian parent.
Yeah, exactly. No, she doesn't. She's your sorority and her sorority. What's the difference in the common end?
Like, a lot of girls like to watch Euphoria or basic shows like that. I feel like the majority of it is connecting with the girl you speak to during recruitment.
Yeah, there's no interest right there. Like, no.
Chaeyoung, how about you? Could you see yourself in a white sorority?
Not really.
How come? Like, why? What do you see?
Not fitting in.
Let me say this, though, right? So now I'm going to be the party pooper here. Y'all know, like, why? Oh, my God. I should be fired. All right, let's get started.
이곳은 미국의 펜실베이니아 주립대.
The title of today's class is Why Aren't We Melting? And I want to have a conversation about this, and we're going to bring it home onto Penn State campus and look at fraternity and sorority life here.
오늘은 나와 다른 사람, 그리고 집단과 다른 집단이 함께 어울리지 못하는 이유와 원인에 대해 이야기합니다. 그리고 모임과 여대생의 생활에 대해서도 직접 들어볼 건데요. 그런데
Oh my God. Oh my God. I should be fired. All right. So
교수님이 인종차별을 한다며 사람들이 불만을 보인 것이었습니다.
We've been struggling with that since the dawn of humanity. I mean, since the very beginning, right? This is a struggle, and it's a struggle all over the world. Okay? So when you see
담담하게 이어가려 했지만 오늘 수업에선 더욱이 그럴 수 없는 노릇이었는데요. 그만큼 위험이 따르는 주제였습니다.
Man, look, first off, hey, can I speak to the stream for a second? Shit. Listen, do me a favor, all right? Everyone close your eyes for a second, okay? Just close your eyes for a second, okay? Listen, here's what's up. Imagine just for a hot minute that you're me, and you're standing up here, and you may or may not have something interesting to say, but, you know, just go for it, man. Put your best face on, and let's do it. We're in this together, okay, cool?
마음에 들지 않아도 이미 수업 중이니 좋은 얼굴로 함께 해보자는 이야기였습니다.
So we're going to talk about fraternities and sororities for a hot minute.
그리고 대학교에서 가장 큰 모임들을 보여주기 시작했는데요. 이상한 점이 있었습니다.
This is the PHC. This is PHC sororities at Penn State. Okay? I've never seen so many white people in a room in all my life. And I kept just looking for the black people or a brown person. And I think I remember seeing one, but whatever. There's a lot of white people there. Okay, so go to the next one, at a university from the Divine Nine. So look, where are the white people? Because, like, you can go to an HBCU, any white people. By the way, if you're white and, like, you want a scholarship, go check out some of the HBCUs because you can be eligible for some scholarship money, you know what I mean, which is kind of cool. Or if you're Asian or Hispanic, but also you can join. It, just because it's historically black doesn't mean you can't join. Like, whatever, go for it, join. Anyway, next one. This might be at Cornell. I forget where this is, or Virginia, I don't remember, or Indiana maybe. So here's the Hispanic chapters. Where are the white people, man? Where are the black people? I guess there's a black Hispanic dude in the back maybe. Yeah, see there in the back on the left. And then here's the next one. This is a Korean chapter, or not, pardon me, not Korean, Asian chapter. This I think is at Cornell. Okay, so you got that? You all see that? All right, you can blacken that. Okay, so we have five volunteers today, and I want you to answer. You're going to answer this question.
참 이상했습니다. 함께 화합하고 융합하기 위해 만들어진 모임이었지만 오늘날까지도 같은 인종끼리 모이는 것이었습니다. 왜 이런 것인지 학생들과 대화 나눠보겠습니다.
So, just say your name and like how you're connected to the Greek life or whatever.
I'm Robert. I'm in SIGEP here.
My name's Callie and I'm in KD.
Hi everyone, my name is Randy Abodi and I am in Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated.
Hi, my name is Manav. I'm an international student from India and I'm not part of any fraternity.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Do you want to be, dude?
Maybe next semester, I've not thought about it.
Because Robert's fraternity is like the most diverse of all the white fraternities.
자신의 모임엔 다양한 학생들이 있다며 자랑스러워하는 로버트 학생. 그런데
How many black and brown people you have?
I'd probably say 10 or like around that number.
Yeah. Wait, how big are you though?
There's like 120 of us.
120, 10. But wait, are the 10 though like are that, wait, that's not funny actually, but.
그만 할 말을 잃고 말았습니다. 그리고 다음 학생이 자기소개를 하는데요.
Hi, I'm Chaeyun and I'm from South Korea.
And have you, did you think about joining a sorority? Yeah. Do you have sororities in Korea at the universities?
여대생 모임이 정확히 뭔지 모르겠다 말한 모양이었습니다.
What is a sorority? Can someone tell her what a sorority is?
A sorority is just like an organization where you do service work and it's about sisterhood.
Yeah, y'all say that, but I was looking. It's basically a place you go to drink. And however, not sororities because they're all on campus, right? But for you all, like for sororities, there's a couple that are like serious, man. Anyway, that's what it is. You go hang out with people who, yeah, you go get ideas for, yeah, whatever. Okay, so listen, here's the deal. Here's what I want the two of you to do. Remember the photos that I showed? Wait, in your sorority, how many black and brown women are there?
There's like one girl who's African, and I think she's mixed. And I'd say there's like a few Hispanic, a few Albanian, but that's about it.
And you?
Yeah, there's one other Asian.
Uh-huh. Hey, do you know where she's from, by the way, Chaeyun? Do you have any idea?
교수님은 갑자기 한국 학생에게 켈리 친구가 어느 나라 사람일지 맞춰보라고 하셨습니다.
I'm not sure.
Yeah?
과연 켈리는 어느 나라 사람이고 또 그게 지금 왜 중요한 걸까요?
Green, can you do a close-up? Do you mind, Callie? Do a close-up? Because she actually has a really cool story.
I might be wrong, but she is mixed and has one Asian parent.
Yeah, exactly. No, she doesn't. She's 100% Chinese. Callie is 100% Chinese, right? Which is so awesome. So Callie is, but you're adopted, right?
백인이 아닌 사람은 아프리카계 혼혈 한 명과 자신이 다라고 했지만 사실 켈리도 완벽히 백인 가정에서만 자라온 입양아였던 것이었습니다.
Okay, so here's what I want you to do. Ready? I want you to figure out from them why it is that they're all not. You got to figure out what's going on. Like, okay, go ahead, man.
이런 현상이 왜 생겼는지 또 아직도 서로 함께하지 않는 것인지 한국 학생과 인도 학생이 모임에 들어가 있는 학생들과 질문을 주고받으며 그 이유를 알아보기로 합니다.
Which qualifications or which criteria you look for in a possible candidate for your frat or sorority?
So nationally, you have to have a 2.75 GPA, but honestly, for my organization, honestly, you are meeting the bare requirements and they're not going to look at you because I think our chapter GPA right now within Penn State, I believe we have a 3.6, so we're not going to look at anybody that's like 2.75 because we're trying to keep our GPA up. And then you have to have, I know for like applications, you have to have a certain amount of community service hours. I know it's over 25 hours. Like that you have to do within yourself, and it has to be within a certain amount of time. You have to have, like, you have to know people in the organization that can vouch for you. You also have to, you can't have a criminal record because they will do a background check on you. You don't have to have leadership positions, but like, honestly, people are looking for those that can lead and like be a change in the community.
인종은 가리지 않지만 사교적이며 평균을 높일 수 있는 사람만 받는다는 것이었습니다.
Do you guys have any like common interests?
Oh, great question. Yeah, do you have any common interests, Callie?
I feel like a lot of common interests for sororities, a lot of it is value-based. So we just talk about like what you do in your free time or what you like to do outside of school, really, what matters. So I guess if you're involved in other organizations, they look for that. Or question. Just outside involvement, really.
So what's the difference between your common interests and Randy's common interests, her and her sorority? Your sorority and her sorority. What's the difference in the common interests?
I mean, I'm sure there probably isn't a lot. Like, a lot of girls like to watch Euphoria or basic shows like that. But I feel like the majority of it is connecting with the girl you speak to during recruitment.
Uh-huh. Do you guys watch Euphoria?
Yeah, there's no interest right there. like, no. So basically with us, I know for my sorority, the like the interest is to serve the Black community and to do public service and to create a sisterhood and create like to create basically a network and a safe space for like people that look like us, but also people that are allies for the Black community.
So could Callie join your sorority?
Yes, Callie can join the sorority, but the thing is like, because there are white people in the sorority, there's like different races in the sorority, but like they all share a common interest to serve the Black community, or they've been allies and they want to create a change within like the world, basically.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Like another thing, like we don't do like recruitment. Like you come to us, you show interest in us, you come to our programs. We're not going out and reaching out and saying like, oh hey, join. Like
가입하고 싶은 사람이 제 발로 오는 것이지 모집 활동을 활발하게 하진 않는다고 답했는데요. 그렇다면 왜 집단 간의 불균형이 생기는 걸까요?
So is not having common interest the main reason for the disproportionation that we see? Like it is majority white dominated.
So is it lack of common interest? Like what is that the main reason?
Yeah, I think that's a huge part of it. It's like there's got to be some sort of factor like common interest or something going on there that would account for that, I would assume.
Bro, what do you think would have taken for you to be interested in a Black or brown fraternity? Would you even consider joining like a Black frat?
Probably not, just because like that's, I don't know, like I would want to go to a group that I see myself like fitting in, and I don't know if I'd, I feel like I'd have a tough time fitting in there.
Chayun, how about you? Could you see yourself in a white sorority?
Not really.
How come? Like, why? What do you see? When you think about being in a white sorority, what do you imagine?
Being different.
You being different?
Yeah.
Yeah? And that would mean what?
Not fitting in.
Uh-huh.
한국 여학생의 답을 끝으로 이번엔 앉아있는 학생이 질문을 하는데요.
Does anyone have a question? Anyone want to?
I was just wondering about, like, do you take into consideration of, like, the LGBTQ plus community? Like, because... for any fraternity or sorority, because I can't tell like if it's just gender neutral, like either male or female.
Yeah, good question.
My sorority does. We do take that into consideration. Like we have.
You mean in a good way, or do you mean to accept people or reject them? Because
no, like we accept them. Yeah. Because like you're not looking at somebody just because they're. They identify a certain way, but like the only thing I know, it was like a big thing. The only thing that we don't take, like that we don't accept, is trans women. And I know that's like been a problem. It's because it's like it's supposed to be those that are who was born a female.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing I would
That'll
say.
That'll change, you know. Right.
Probably not.
No, I don't. Not change. Gonna lie. Nah, even Black people do. Dude, by the way, there's so much homophobia in the Black community.
Yeah.
Like, I can't even begin to walk down that road. But even with that, that will change in time, man. Maybe not in the next 10 years, but it'll change. Everything's changing.
Probably like, down, yeah, like years, 100 years maybe.
흑인 여성의 편의와 인권 운동을 하지만 성소수자는 문제를 일으키기 때문에 받아들이지 않는다는 흑인 여학생. 교수님은 다시 입을 뗐습니다.
Okay, so listen, let me say this though, right? So now I'm going to be the party pooper here. You all know like why everyone's always recruiting and recruiting and recruiting, and like Penn State, we're always hearing about all the diversity initiatives and we're out trying to bring people in. So you know how we're always like putting so much effort into trying to build a connection with people, right? And so you hear it all the time, and all this diversity recruitment and diversity initiative and da 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 da. And you're like, holy shit! Like it's everywhere. It's so everywhere. Like why? It's like you feel sometimes like people are like these organizations and companies and universities are like ramming it down our throats all the time. Do you feel like that as an outsider? I feel like that's here in the U.S. You see that all the time? Yeah? So look at the reason is because if we just let people go on the basis of what they're comfortable with, right? nothing changes. Like your organization is, your two organizations are white. Your organization is black, right? The other organizations are Asian or Hispanic or whatever. It's like nothing changes. It's like what happens is you got to go out and force it. It's not about what you're comfortable with, right? It's about what you're uncomfortable with. So this is the problem.
다양성을 중시한다면서 결국 나와 다른 사람은 받아들이지 않을 거라는 말에 교수님은 편안함만 쫓는다면 아무것도 바뀌지 않는다는 말씀을 하셨습니다. 그러자 흑인 여학생은 이렇게 답합니다.
What do you think would have to happen for 10 years from now that I'm not having this conversation? Like, what would have to happen?
I mean, I'm not a pessimist, but I think because like the history of why our organizations were founded in the first place,
yeah.
It's like, it's not gonna move away from that, but we are open. Like there's been, I've seen like girls join my sorority just like because they share a common interest or they feel like they identify more within with our goals. So I think it's more so like how you present yourself and like what you do, like the programs that you put on. I think that's it. And it's just like other people have to be willing to like go and expand themselves. Yeah. But like you also have to be accepting of other people.
오늘은 많은 집단들이 왜 서로 섞이지 못하는지 그 이유와 원인에 대해 알아보는 시간을 가졌습니다. 크게는 인종 간, 국가 간, 남녀 간, 나이, 직업, 정말 많은 경계가 그어져 있고 수많은 집단들로 나뉘어져 있습니다. 어떤 사람들은 집단에 속해 있지 않으면 불안하고 불편함을 느낀다고도 하는데요. 강의 마지막에 교수님은 이렇게 말씀하셨습니다. 서로 그어놓은 선을 잊어버린다 해도 불편할 것이 없다는 것이었습니다. 사실 모든 게 그대로라는 것이죠. 너와 나 사이에 선을 긋고 우린 전혀 다르다고 말하는 순간 불편이 생기고 나와 다르다 여기는 것에서부터 차별이 생겨난다는 것입니다. 우리 한국은 다른 나라보다 모임이 별로 없는 편이라 하죠. 그렇기 때문에 오늘 강의에서 각자 다른 모임에 들어가 있는 학생들을 상대로 질문을 주고받으며 대화 속에서 함께 알아보자고 했던 것이 어쩌면 멀게 느껴졌을 수도 있습니다. 역시 우리 한국과 미국은 문화가 다르니 이해하기 어렵다는 것이죠. 하지만 대화가 진행될수록 점점 이해가 되는 듯 했습니다. 우리나라에도 세대 간 갈등이나 성별 갈등이 존재하니까 말이죠. 편한 곳에 있다 해서 상황이 바뀌진 않습니다. 서로가 갈등을 해결하려 노력하고 또 함께 많은 대화를 나눠야 해결되는 문제들이 있을 테니까요. 오늘 질문 역할을 맡은 한국 여학생이 답답해 보인 분들도 계실 것 같은데요. 하지만 오늘 강의에서 봤듯 한국 여학생은 한국이 아닌 다른 나라에서 영어를 하며 외국인들과 함께 대화를 해야 하니 여간 어려운 일이 아니었을 것 같습니다. 하지만 이렇게 대화를 나누다 보면 언젠가는 자신감을 찾을 수 있지 않을까 생각합니다. 오늘 강의는 여기까지입니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다. 강의를 해주신 샘 리처드 교수님 감사합니다.